back. Welcome to my channel. So my name is Nkandu, and today I will be telling you all the things you know. Hi everyone, welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name is Nkandu. Today I will be telling you about all the things you need to know before you get your driver's license in Zambia. So the first thing you have to know is that there are two tests. There's the theory and the practical test. In the theory test, the requirements are your NRC photocopy and your medicals. So there are three sections in the theory test. The first section is the 10 basic rules. You can find them, the 10 basic rules, in the Zambian Highway Code on page 25. You can find them here. You're supposed to master exactly the words in board, 10 of them. Yeah. And then the other thing you're supposed to know are the signs. You can find them here. There are 57 signs. You can find them here. You have to know the signs. Not everything comes, but some of them come. Yeah, so, and then the other thing you're supposed to know are the general knowledge questions, which are not that hard. So for you to pass the test, you're supposed to get at least 6 out of 10 on the 10 basic rules, at least 30 something signs out of 50 something on the signs, and the general knowledge, you're supposed to get at least a 6 for you to pass the test. So if you pass the test, you're going to be given your provision. So yeah, now let's get into the practical part of the test. There are two sections in the practical. There are the coins and the road driving, you driving on the road with the instructor. So on the coins, yes, there's a Y junction. So you're supposed to go forward, you turn right, reverse right, go forward again, turn left, reverse left. Yeah, so the coins are a bit tricky. For my experience, I prefer driving on the road than the coins, because the coins were a bit hard. Yeah, so that's all you need to know about the coins. Then for driving on the road with the examiner, you are supposed to put your seatbelt on and tell the examiner to put their seatbelt on if they haven't already. Yeah, so the things you are supposed to avoid when you're on the road with the examiner. Firstly, you have to follow their instructions. They'll tell you turn left, turn right. So follow their instructions. Secondly, you are not supposed to cross your hands. Like when turning, crossing your hands like that. You are just supposed to push and pull. to turn and, yeah, you get. You're supposed to turn like this, not crossing your hands. I don't know if it makes sense, but yeah. Then the other thing you're supposed to avoid is the speed limits. You're not supposed to pass the speed limit of 40. You are supposed to drive 40 and below. Then the other thing, the zebra crossing, you're supposed to stop when there's someone coming. If someone wants to cross, you're supposed to stop and turn on your hazards. Then the other thing you're supposed to avoid, the traffic lights. You're supposed to follow the lights. If it's green, you go. If it's red, you stop. If it's orange, you stop. Yeah. So let me talk about my experience when I went on the road with the examiner. So I was scared, but the examiner was actually very social. He was talking. Yeah, I guess they do that to just calm you down. So when I was on the road, he told me the route. He told me he's going to be telling me when to turn. Yeah. So the first time, sadly, I didn't make it because I did not follow the traffic lights. I just turned because it car turned. I also followed. So the first time was actually bad. But he told me since I passed in the cones, I can go the other week to redo the on the road. So that day, I was actually confident because I knew the route and it was actually the same examiner. So I started the car, put on my seatbelt. He already had his seatbelt on. Then when we reached the traffic lights, I stopped, I chilled, I took my time until the lights turned green, that's when I went. And then we went back to the to Ridgeway. Then there he rode past and blah blah blah. Then he told me to go into a room, then I took my papers there. Then there they gave us other forms to sign. Yeah. And then I was told to go get my license. I was actually very happy when I heard I passed. I was with some other girl, she also passed. So it was actually a fun experience. So if you're scared, just go try it out. So this is how my license looks like. There's a picture. I looked very upset. And then it says driver's license. Then class B, the vehicle. And also, if I didn't mention, I drive automatic. Yeah, so that's all you need to know before you go take your test. So don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications so that you get notified whenever I post. Stay tuned for more videos. Bye.